Have you ever wanted to switch Kickstart versions without opening your Amiga or swapping ROM chips? Or maybe you're a developer who needs to test firmware across different Kickstart environments quickly? Now you can. The SidecarTridge Kickstart Emulator uses advanced bit-banged emulation to replicate the internal ROMs of the Commodore Amiga. You can run any Kickstart version or diagnostic ROM instantly. What used to be a hassle is now simple. Connect the device over USB, transfer your Kickstart image files, and select the version you want using a small program on your Amiga. You can even upload new Kickstart images directly from the running system. No tools, no ROM swapping, just switch and go. Before we start, let's make sure your Commodore Amiga is compatible. This version works plug and play on the Amiga 500 and Amiga 2000. For the Amiga 500, you'll need to confirm the motherboard revision by opening the case and checking. Revision 3, no silkscreen above the memory chips. Revision 5, 16 RAM chips, all populated with a white A500 silkscreen. Revision 6, the same white A500 silkscreen, but only 8 RAM chip positions. Check the compatibility section for the full list. If your board isn't listed, just contact us. If your ROM is socketed, you're good to go. If it's soldered, it must be desoldered and placed into sockets. If you're not comfortable doing this, get professional help to avoid damage. Once you've confirmed your motherboard, choose the correct SidecarTridge Kickstart Emulator kit for your model. After you receive your kit, make sure you have everything for a smooth setup. Inside the box, you should find the SidecarTridge ROM emulator board, pre-soldered onto the carrier board. The rescue cable and push button for rescue mode. SidecarTridge documentation. Scan the QR code on the device or visit docs.sidecartridge.com. You will also need a USB-C data cable for connecting the emulator to a computer. Any data-capable cable will work. Recommended tools: an IC extractor to safely remove ROM chips, a flathead screwdriver if you don't have an extractor, a computer with a USB port for transferring ROM files and updating firmware, Kickstart, diagnostic, or custom ROM images. The device does not include Kickstart files due to copyright. You can extract them from your own ROMs or purchase them through Amiga Forever Plus Edition at AmigaForever.com. Switcher, the program used to select and manage Kickstart images. It's available on the SidecarTridge website and is also included in the default volume in executable and ADF format. The SidecarTridge Kickstart emulator has two modes: mass storage mode, used to transfer Kickstart and other ROM image files; ROM emulation mode, used to boot the Amiga with the selected ROM. To enter mass storage mode, connect the SidecarTridge Kickstart emulator to your computer using a USB-C cable. It can remain attached to the Amiga, but when powered from USB, it will switch into mass storage mode. The orange LED confirms the mode is active. If the ROM wall volume does not appear, check the USB connection and press the reset button on the SidecarTridge Kickstart ROM board for a few seconds. Once the volume mounts, open ROM wall on your computer. You will see the system files used to manage the device. The Kickstart emulator supports any genuine ROM dump in the original format. If you choose to acquire the Amiga Forever Plus ISO, you'll find the ROM files in a proprietary encoded format. To convert them into the original Amiga format, use the Kickstart conversion tool available at sidecartridge.com/kickstartconverter. Open the Amiga Files shared ROM folder, drag and drop, or select the ROM images you want to convert. Next, locate and upload the ROM.key file. Finally, click Decode and Download to decode all ROM files into the original format and download them to a temporary folder. To copy ROM image files, just drag them into the ROM-em-all volume. The emulator will store them automatically in its internal file system. For safety, keep a backup of your ROM files on your computer. Update the default.txt file and write the name of the ROM you want to use as the default. Then edit rescue.txt and enter the ROM file you want the system to use if the default one fails. Don't forget to save both files. After copying, make sure to unmount the ROM-em-all volume so your computer flushes the cache. We won't go into detail on opening the Amiga case. There are plenty of tutorials available. Once the metal shield is removed, locate the ROM chips. For the Amiga 500, they are on the left side of the motherboard, near the Motorola 68000. If the ROM chips are soldered, seek professional help. This guide assumes they are socketed. To remove the ROM, use a chip extractor to lift it gently. If you don't have one, carefully insert a flathead screwdriver under one side of the chip and pry it up slowly, then repeat on the other side until it comes free. Once removed, place the chip on an anti-static surface or inside an anti-static bag. Inspect the empty socket and clean it if needed with compressed air or a soft brush. Now install the SidecarTridge Kickstart Emulator. Orientation depends on the motherboard. For the A500, the carrier board plugs into the ROM socket with the emulator sitting to the right, above the memory chips. Before closing the case, power on the Amiga and verify the emulator boots using the default ROM. If it doesn't, power off, recheck the installation, and follow the troubleshooting section if needed. Make sure nothing touches the metal shield or nearby components. Add insulating tape if required before reassembling the case. Now that the device is installed and working, here's how to use it day to day. Power on the Amiga as usual. The SidecarTridge Kickstart Emulator will boot using the active ROM. As mentioned earlier, you must obtain valid Kickstart ROMs from reliable sources. To switch versions, use the Switcher program. It's available from the documentation page and also preloaded in the default volume. Copy it to your Amiga and run it like any other program. There is also an ADF version for GoTech users. Switcher shows all available ROM images, the active ROM marked with A, the rescue ROM marked with R. Use the arrow keys to navigate and press return to select a ROM. The Amiga will reboot with the new version. This is the recommended way to switch Kickstart images. While you can change ROMs by editing the default TXT file, as explained in the documentation, it's not advised for daily use. You can also upload a new ROM directly from the Amiga. Make sure the file is stored on accessible media and press U. Select the drive, browse to the image, and press return to start the upload. In real time, this takes around 3 to 5 minutes, depending on size. When finished, Switcher will re-index the list and the new ROM will appear in the menu. To delete a ROM, press D from the main menu and confirm. The app will re-index automatically. For safety, the active and rescue ROMs cannot be deleted. This completes the quick start. For more details, visit the documentation site. Enjoy.